She's unique. She's one of a kind.
We like the style, we like the audacity, we like the freshness.
So unique and creative.
Yeah, nobody else could copy her.
Very feminine, also very sexy, sometimes a bit slutty, which I think is nice actually.
I'm not a good blonde, and I think she's better as a brunette, so I'm going for the brunette look.
Tell me about what you're wearing.
Vivian Westwood.
I was wondering if it's something from House of Gaga, because that's your band of stylists.
House of Westwood.
House of Westwood, got it. But do you choose your styles and your wardrobe yourself, or do you have a team of stylists behind you?
Well, my team is myself.
Yeah.
We all sleep and breathe and eat our work every day. So it's sort of an ongoing dialogue. Look what I found. Ooh, I should wear this. Look what we made. You never really know, but it certainly all comes from us together. We're a collective.
There's this entity called House of Gaga. Could you tell me what that is?
I chose the word house to basically pay tribute to all of the voguing houses in New York City, as well as the Bauhaus, the art school.
Because it's spelled H-A-U-S.
H-A-U-S.
And you've showcased some pretty incredible outfits, you know, recently. The bubble dress comes to mind.
Saint Chalayan.
And do you have a favorite outfit yourself?
I love the bubble dress.
Yeah.
Hussein Chalayan is a designer that has inspired the house for some time. I love that outfit. And the Judy Jetson outfit that the house designed, that has been something I've worn over and over again in the show. Each one of my outfits holds a very different and special place for me.
Now, you embraced pop culture in a big way, at least wardrobe-wise, in the Kermit the Frog cloak that you wore. And I was wondering if you could explain the thinking behind that.
It's not mine. I didn't design it. It was designed by Jean de Castelbajac, and the house loves his work, and he sent it to me, and I wanted to support him, and I loved it so much. I mean, that's pop art fashion at its best.
And there's also,
I had no idea it would cause such a, I mean, we're in China and yeah. You're asking me about it. It's kind of crazy, right? We were laughing because I said it was kind of like commentary on wearing fur because it was a bunch of dead Kermit. I don't wear fur.
There's also the pyrotechnic bra that you've worn on
we
stage.
We made that.
The House of Gaga made that.
House of Gaga, yeah, we designed that.
Yeah, how much engineering went into that?
A lot of engineering. There's a lot of thought process that goes into it. We didn't have very much time. I was in Hawaii at my friend photographer's house on vacation, and I was like smoking weed in the woods, like running around naked, and I came up with this idea, and I called Maddie Dada, and I said, you gotta make my blow up. He said, what are you talking about? And I said, I want my tits need to blow up. I said, women, our sexual parts are seen as weapons. So design me my weapons. He said, I don't know how I'm going to get them into Canada. We can't make explosives. I don't even know if I can put explosives on your body. I don't know if I can light you on fire. And I said, do it. And then we hung up. And 6 hours later, the house called me and they told me how they would make it, what legalities we had to have in order to do it, the best way to do it without having to sign anything or have a fire marshal at the performance, as well as sketches. I've got some really smart friends.
I wanted to ask you about your tattoos, because you recently picked one up in Japan.
I got two.
Could you show them to us and tell us
yeah,
about them?
I could show you this one.
Oh, the typeface is gorgeous.
Thank you. It's in German.
And what is it? What does it say?
It says it's a quote by a German philosopher. I call him a philosopher. He's a poet. And it says, confess to yourself in the deepest hour of the night whether you would have to die if you are forbidden to write. look deep into your heart where it spreads its roots to find the answer and ask yourself, must I write? Must. And that's like the italicized must.
Does this speak to you as a songwriter?
I mean, of course it does, but it's not just like a quote I looked up on the internet. I've been reading Rilke since I was 15, so that's 8 years ago, and I've been living my life endlessly by this book called Letters to a Young Poet. For me, in my darkest moments as an artist, I turned to this book to reinvigorate my spirit.
Now let's go back to your background and want to ask you what it was like being Gaga as a kid. And I can gather that you weren't a shy kid. Did you like showing off?
I was a real pain in the ass.
Yeah. How so? What did you do?
I just was very loud. I was always singing and dancing, and my father was always laughing with me. And I had a great childhood. I just was a very dramatic young woman. During free time, I was in the chapel playing some classical piece that I was learning or writing music. I just was a very creative young woman. And I'm just a very secluded person. I mean, just in all honesty, I only associate now even with the people that I work with. I don't really have many friends, and it's the life that I choose. My very sweet girl who does my makeup, who travels with us all over the world, she was laughing at me, I think it was yesterday. She said, you're crazy. And I said, I'm not crazy. She said, yes, you are. And she said, you sleep with a wig on your head. And you think it's normal.
Because you're Gaga at 24 hours.
It's not that. I just like wigs.
So when did you first perform?
I don't know. My whole life is a performance.
How did you break into the industry?
I was a relentless bitch.
Getting your way to get a chance to perform on a stage?
I was performing on stages my whole life. I performed in nightclubs when I was 15. I went to college for musical theater. I dropped out. I became a burlesque. I mean, I just couldn't tell you. I was born on a stage, and I'll die on one for sure. I'm not even gonna answer that question. We didn't need to. We didn't.
No, no, no.